Beloved, today I want you to know that you are a child of God. For you to be a child of God is an assurance that God created you. You belong to Him. That's what He said in the book of Genesis chapter 1. He said, let us make man in our own image according to our own likeness. Let's turn to the book of Romans chapter 8, verse 14. And 15. Romans chapter 8, verse 14 and 15. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, you are sons of God. For you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you received the spirit of adoption, by whom we cry out, Abba, Father. Beloved, God is a good father. He loves you with love that is matchless and unwavering. Our outer fathers have important jobs, roles to play in our life. To do this, guide us, they guide you to love one another. And God taught us, in His own words, to love one another, to love your neighbors. Including our earthly father, have to teach you how to love God, how to go to church, how to pray, how to acknowledge Him, how to be sincere with God. Those are the works of our earthly father that provide the means, the things that we need. It is not, people say, it is not an obligation, but it is a responsibility for our earthly fathers to do those things. Because the Bible says, if a man don't take care of their children, that man is an infidel. But this is what our Heavenly Father do. Our Heavenly Father always guide us, protect us. He have mercy on us. He show us compassion, His boundless love, is matchless. No matter the flaws or the mistakes we do in life, beloved, our Heavenly Father show us compassionate love. He always protect us. Today I want to encourage each and every one of us, submit yourself to our Heavenly Father. God have given us the privilege of the Holy Spirit to lead us in the truth and in action. The Spirit is described as a proof that we are adopted in God's family as His children. You can take this claim of your rights, beloved, as God's precious and beloved child. Beloved, take this claim. It's your right to accept God, to accept Jesus as your personal Savior. If you have not accepted Him yet, today I encourage you to accept Jesus to come into your life. God bless you.